Now, when you launch a tech product, you need a marketing website to promote your app or software. Now, designing a website and designing an app might sound similar, but in reality, the process behind it, the approach behind it is completely different. A website is a product because it's technically a digital product that you code and publish, but website designers are different from product designers. Now, there are many ways to make a website. You design, you develop, and you publish. But if you are just starting with your company, you should prioritize on making things easier for you. The best way to publish a website is to get a template and then edit on top of that template. So you skip all the major efforts of building things from scratch. Even in templates, I would recommend you to choose a software or a technology that requires minimum amount of coding. So there is this new section of softwares that is now being introduced, and they are called no-code tools. Now there are many tools that directly convert your Figma files into code, but I recommend you to try out Webflow. This is again not a paid promotion. I am recommending you Webflow simply because I have used it and I have seen it work for many other brands. Webflow is a no-code tool. It is being loved by both designers and developers, and Webflow has a lot of templates, both free and paid. So when you buy a template from Webflow, you save a lot of time because their templates are responsive. So when you make something on Webflow, when you buy a template or when you use their free templates, they work pretty well on phones and tablets and computers, so you don't have to worry about all these various edge cases. So I'll tell you a step-by-step process for launching your website. The most important thing is to get your domain name. For example, I had to buy anshmehra.com so that nobody else could reserve that name for me. So once your brand name is logged, once your app's name is logged, please get your domain names sorted. You don't need to build a website to buy a domain name. You might buy a domain name in January and start building your website in December. That is completely okay. But reserve your domain name as soon as you can. Now you can get domain names from Google Domains. That is a website that I regularly use because it allows you to compare multiple prices. So you can put your suitable name and Google Domains will tell you all the various prices for .com, .in, .org and so on. Then you need a template because you have that .com name with you, but how does the website look like? For that you need a visual template. That can be purchased on Webflow. So Webflow has many templates. You can get a template that suits your need and then edit that template. Third thing is hosting that template, because whatever things that you've edited are just on your computer. So you need to put it on the internet. For that, Webflow only has multiple subscriptions. So you pay an annual fee to host your website. So you get your .com domain and you connect that .com domain to your Webflow subscription. You take the Webflow template and then you upload it because of that subscription. So moving ahead, you need two main people to launch your website. One is going to be your web designer and the other is going to be your web developer. The web designer is going to be responsible for editing the template and adding images and adding videos, whatever it is that you want to add on the website. The web developer is going to be responsible for buying the domain, connecting it to the Webflow subscription, hosting things online, maintaining if the website crashes or cracks or whatever it is, all the technical stuff. Now, a lot of people code their applications using HTML, CSS and WordPress. You can always explore those options. I am recommending you Webflow simply because their templates are absolutely gorgeous and there are so many cool things that you can do without any coding. There's one small thing that you'd have to change while hiring. Instead of looking for web developers, you need to look for a Webflow developer, because web developers traditionally use HTML and CSS, which is manual hand-based coding, but Webflow developers are specialized in Webflow. And Webflow is like a separate tool. It's like Figma, where you literally drag and drop and make things happen very easily. So your Webflow developer is responsible for putting things online on Webflow. And then you can have a normal web designer as well. There is no such thing as Webflow designer. You simply need a web designer. So that web designer will help you fine-tune your template and add whatever visual things that you want to have. So in a lot of cases, you will find Webflow developers who are both designers and developers. So they are called unicorns because they do both design and development. So if you find someone like that, 100% get them. Another common question is that, Ansh, why would you make us select a template when we can easily build things from scratch? I would recommend you to save time in the beginning when you're just launching your product, because a lot of people get too busy into their branding and their website and their marketing and exhaust all the time that they could have spent working on the product. In the beginning, spend maximum energy on making your product good. Pick a template for the website, pick basic colors and typefaces, it's still all right, but you can't have an average product. Spend maximum amount of time with your product designers who are making the product, because a good website and a bad product will not get you customers. But the combination of a decent website and a good product will get you customers and revenue in the longer run. So prioritize having a good product and kind of like an okay website that doesn't look too terrible, which is easily possible by just editing a ready available template. Now, when it comes to salaries, on average, a Webflow developer who both designs and develops takes around 1 lakh rupees a month. This is in August 2022, and they usually finish the website within a month itself. So what they do is they take 30 days and they split 30 days into three buckets. First 10 days are spent on asking questions and making initial wireframes. Then the second 10 day gap is used for making the initial designs, showing you the visual design, and the last 10 days are required for coding the entire website. So in those 30 days they make the first draft, and another month is sort of spent on making iterations, fixing things, making things look perfect. So usually these freelancers charge 1 lakh rupees per month, the good ones, but in a lot of cases really bad Webflow designers also charge you a lot of money. So be very careful, please see their work, see their live work, check their work on both phones and computers and tablets, because responsiveness is a very, very important quality. What do I mean by that? When I say that a website is responsive, it means that it would run very smoothly on phone, tablet and computers. On all devices, it runs properly. But again, this price is also very variable, because as you add more pages and more animations to your website, the cost goes up. I would not recommend you to make a complicated website in the beginning, as I mentioned, because making your first app is way more important than making a very fancy website. Now, I would not recommend you to directly get a full-time Webflow developer or a full-time web designer, simply because once a basic website is made, you don't need to make a lot of regular changes as time goes on. You need to have full-time product folks, but you can basically outsource your website creation to a Webflow developer, get them for 2 months, and then just have them in regular intervals if you want to add major changes to your website. So to quickly summarize the overall process, you take a template, you discuss with your web designer, the web designer makes changes to that template, he makes assets, he makes the images, gives the Figma file to the Webflow developer, and then the Webflow developer implements all the designs given by your web designer. This is how it usually works. Once all of your work is done, you simply pay Webflow to host that website on the internet, and you connect that Webflow website with your domain name. You can make a website like this, like take a template and edit it and push it on the internet, but you can't make a product like this. Please make sure that you don't confuse this web design strategy with product design strategy. When it comes to a product, you can't pick a template, change it, and launch it as a new app. Making a product requires a lot of research, a lot of prototyping, a lot of testing. So this course is primarily about product designing. This video was just like a quick overview. If you quickly want to get a website made, so you can take these shortcuts for the websites, but please don't take these shortcuts when it comes to your product. If you want to have some web design inspiration, I will post some really, really cool links in the description. Check out each and every link. They would have hundreds of websites that you can take inspiration from. I took around 2 years to collect these links, so they will be very helpful to you when you launch your first website. So yes, I hope that you now understand the basic process of launching a website. You understand that web designing and product designing are two different processes. They require different mindsets. You also got to know about templates and no-code tools. You can explore other no-code tools as well by going on Google and searching no-code tools for websites. Those are the best ones, the easiest ones to implement. Don't forget to document your learnings. I will see you in the next video. If you like this video, make sure you click on like and hit the subscribe button. I regularly upload videos on UX design, marketing, and storytelling.